On November 27th, 1964, the cameras rolled. The pilot of a new science fiction series was launched. The sound stages were falling apart, and the production was running into problems. After 16 days shooting at a cost of more than $600,000, the first pilot was over schedule and over budget, and the network gave it thumbs down. But even though NBC didn't like the cage, they did like the idea of the show, so they asked for an unprecedented second pilot, where no man has gone before. But before that, there was The Cage, Star Trek in its original form. The network executives thought this episode was too cerebral and that there wasn't enough action. It was too erotic. And they were skeptical about the character of Number One. And oh yes, they also hated the guy with the pointy ears. They felt he was too satanic. He'd have to go. But the pilot did prove to the network that you could make a weekly science fiction series that was intelligent, complex, provocative, and believable. Star Trek was on its way. So that was how it started. From Gene Roddenberry's mind and an amazing production team came this vision of the future. The series was more than just another television program. Star Trek gave us new forms of science and technology. It gave us new spaceships with new means of propulsion, new aliens, religions, customs, and planets. In short, The Cage created a new galaxy, and the 79 episodes which followed filled it with imagination.